Former President Donald Trump thanked the millions of decent, hard-working, law-abiding, God and country-loving citizens and blasted the Democratic Party after the U.S. Senate acquitted him in his second impeachment trial on Saturday. 43 senators, all Republicans, voted to acquit Trump, while 57 senators, including 7 Republicans, voted to convict, falling shy of the constitutional requirement of a two-thirds majority needed to convict. Trump had been accused of inciting the deadly riot at the U.S. Capitol on January 6th, the day in which Congress and then Vice President Mike Pence counted the electoral votes to confirm the results of the 2020 presidential election. In a statement, Trump thanked the senators and members of Congress who stood proudly for the Constitution we all revere and for the sacred legal principles at the heart of our country. "This has been yet another phase of the greatest witch hunt in the history of our country," Trump argued. "No president has ever gone through anything like it, and it continues because our opponent cannot forget the almost 75 million people, the highest ever for a sitting president, who voted for us just a few short months ago." Trump assured that America remains one glorious nation under God and stressed that it is our responsibility to preserve this magnificent inheritance for our children and for generations of Americans to come. "May God bless all of you, and may God forever bless the United States of America," he concluded. The 7 Republicans who voted for conviction are Senators Bill Cassidy of Louisiana, Richard Burr of North Carolina, Mitt Romney of Utah, Susan Collins of Maine, Lisa of Alaska, Ben Sasse of Nebraska, and Pat Toomey of Pennsylvania. As a result of the President Trump's actions, for the first time in American history, the transfer of presidential power was not peaceful, Toomey said in a statement. "A lawless attempt to retain power by a president was one of the founders' greatest fears, motivating the inclusion of the impeachment authorities in the U.S. Constitution." Senator Toomey, a Republican from Alabama who voted to acquit, said he had concerns with the lack of due process and constitutionality of this trial. Toomey, a first-time senator and former college football coach, said in a statement he doesn't think the Senate has the authority to try a private citizen. Senator James Lankford, R. Okla, agreed. "I cannot support removing someone from office who is not in office," Lankford, who voted to acquit, said. "An impeachment trial after someone has left office is unconstitutional." Republican Senator Marshall Blackburn from Tennessee, who also voted for acquittal, accused the House impeachment managers of launching an unconstitutional show trial to humiliate the former president and his supporters. In his statement, Trump accused the Democratic Party of being given a free pass to denigrate the rule of law, defame law enforcement, cheer mobs, excuse rioters, and transform justice into a tool of political vengeance, and persecute, blacklist, cancel, and suppress all people and viewpoints with whom or which they disagree. The storming of the U.S. Capitol on January 6th came on the same day Trump delivered a speech at the Save America March at the Ellipse near the White House that was peacefully attended by thousands of his supporters. After his speech, thousands walked to the Capitol, where a separate planned rally was to be held that afternoon. That event, however, never took place because the riot had ensued. In his speech to supporters, Trump said Republicans needed to fight much harder. He also urged them to protest the certification of the election results, which he argued were tainted by voter fraud. "We are going to cheer on brave senators and congressmen and women, and we are probably not going to be cheering so much for some of them," Trump said in his speech, "because you will never take back our country with weakness. You have to show strength and you have to be strong. I know that everyone here will soon be marching over to the Capitol building to peacefully and patriotically make your voices heard." In his closing argument, defense lawyer Michael Van Der Veen contended that Trump did incite the violence. "The act of incitement never happened," Van Der Veen said. The violence was pre-planned and premeditated by a group of lawless actors who must be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law.